COVID-19 cleared out this playground 2 months ago. Since then, the pandemic has been wreaking havoc on the mental and emotional health of adults. And now a new survey shows it's having a powerful impact on kids as well.
And their social environment is so important for their own cognitive development, their own emotional, social development.
This is not your typical grade 6 math class. COVID-19 has completely transformed the traditional classroom. And a new Angus Reid survey suggests kids are feeling the COVID crunch. 29% of kids across the country are worried about missing out on the next school year. 27% worried about missing out on this year. And 26% worried about their family getting sick.
As much as we feel this sort of, anxiety about not knowing what's going to happen in the next few months, they feel it, and it's even worse for them because their life is like that in general, right? They're dependent on you. And if the adults in their lives are going on with this anxiety, well, they're going to feel it as well.
Feeling cooped up? Well, here are 5 ways that can help you get through isolation.
The survey canvassed kids between 10 and 17 years old from coast to coast. These kids shared some of their COVID concerns with City News.
I think it's sometimes hard for kids because like all the fun places are closed and you can't go anywhere.
There's a lot of sports that both of us participate in,
yep,
and we're not able to do it right now.
I do not like online school.
The Angus Reid survey also found 71% of kids say they're feeling bored, 41% normal, and 33% lonely. AbbaZaid says it's important to provide your kids with purpose to help counter the COVID blues.
Try to provide the kids with control over their lives because that's really what's most pressing and stressful about life in general is feeling that loss of control. And if they can at least control one small aspect of their lives, they can build on that.
Or you can just try social media.
Stay positive, be active.
TikTok videos is what we've been doing.
Family. In Russell, Ontario, Nigel Newlove, City News.